Welcome back. So you need a lot of energy to cycle from morning till evening. So any special diet that you...
I think diet's one thing you have to take care, because your stomach has a limited capacity. Your digestive system has a special, you know, it has a limited capacity to digest things. So I think if you have some a capacity, you have to take very... you are thirsty, if you drink 2 liters of water, your stomach is full. You don't have energy, but your stomach is full. You cannot eat anything. Your stomach is full. You are not getting in energy. You cannot eat anything.
Absolutely.
Your stomach is full. So that happens. So I have kind of stopped drinking water these days. So it's like I always have glucose and something. I like put it in water and I carry those bottles with me. So that is, I think.
But doesn't that leave you dehydrated?
Water, it's water, it's
no,
water.
No, because you're not consuming too much water?
No, I consume some 15 liters of water every day.
Oh my God, okay.
So 10-15 bottles are very usual. So okay. Initially in the morning, very first 2 or 3 bottles I have that glucose. Then you cannot help it. You'll have to have water. You cannot carry so much of glucose with you, right? Mm. So then you have to have water. Regarding the other, the breakfast, lunch and dinner, I think these all terms have lost in like their meaning. Whenever I get food, I'll eat it. I'll not go into you have to have a light breakfast, heavy breakfast.
Okay.
I'll eat heaviest anything that I get. So I'll have a stomach full of meal. Then I'll proceed. Whenever I'll get food in the evening or something. So it's like in the morning 10 I have breakfast something. Then after that I have at 3 or 4 and then in the night.
Okay, but there are some foods that immediately put you to sleep. You know, they give you that drowsy feeling. So did you avoid them? Did you ensure that you ate only, you know, a certain kind of...
That dizziness happens. I think one picture is being played here where there were no trees or shade or something. So I got shade behind a very big rock. So I was carrying bed sheet. So I just had put the bed sheet there and parked my bicycle. I just went off to sleep. So it was after 2 hours I woke up and then like happened. So I have done that thing just on the side of the road and where there are bushes, you know, plantation and something. And then there was a time I slept in this Telangana bus stop. There was a bus stop in Telangana state. So these bus stops are covered, and the very best facility that they have is like they have a water tank just beside every bus stop.
Okay.
Right. So I slept there. So if I feel drowsy or something, I sleep. It's okay. Happens.
Okay. Because you were experimenting so much with water and food, your stomach never got spoiled or anything.
Nothing happens. People even say that, okay, if you cycle, my father used to say, if you cycle just after having food, and you might get ill, sick, or have problems there. I think nothing happens. Nothing happens. But I would not advise anyone.
Well, we
to
sure
have
hope
it.
That continues, Gaurav. We'll be looking forward to your book or blog, whatever that comes about. But any other journey that you've planned, looking at the kind of success or looking at the kind of joy that this journey has given you, any other journey that you've planned, any other trek?
I don't think I have any journey planned right now, because right now my mother says, "You come back, I'll make you Gaurav." Okay. I have turned to like black. I'm like tanned, heavily tanned. So she says.
So she's very upset about that.
She's upset as well as she's happy. Okay, traveling. So yeah, and she was very upset when I used to tell people that okay, mom has not allowed me. Mom has not allowed me. So anywhere if she's hearing, it's okay. She was the one who allowed me, and permissions all echoes to her.
You can send across this particular show to her so that.
Yeah, perfect. I'll do that.
You can
I'll
send
do
a
that.
Message through this show.
Because she's the entire day she's tracking me on GPS. When like as I told you, when I entered Narmada, she was like, "Ki, you don't have to enter the river, okay?" I said, "Okay, fine." Then I turned off my GPS. I went inside the river. I came out after a kilometer. I turned on the GPS again. So she said, "Okay, fine." The next day she saw the picture and she was like, "Ki, okay, you went in the river." I said, "Yes."
Oh, so you've already broken the condition. So this particular journey, as you said, so far you feel that you've been unchanged, but there will be some sort of a change.
Unchanged, as I said, as I feel it unchanged, because you get used to it. Somebody was asking, okay, how does it feel when the terrain changes, when there are mountains, when there are rivers? It doesn't change all of a sudden, okay? When the mountains change, when the mountains end, they don't end abruptly, right? They end over a period of some, 30, 40, 80 kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
So you're so used to it that you don't feel the change.
Okay.
You are very, accustomed to that thing. Okay, when if you ask me from where does this heat and the, hot region start, I won't be able to say, because it has gradually started increasing, right? So that is the same thing. If you ask me what has changed, something has so gradually changed that I won't be able to, pick it up.
Okay.
That would be something that, okay, when did you first learn this? When did you first say that word or something? Mm-hmm. So it has, initially it has very gradually started seeping.
Okay, so you can't put a finger on it.
Exactly.
Okay.
So there is no black and white. It's all gray.
It's all gray. And you like that. So has it done any sort of a change to your confidence? You know, you're just 22 years old and you had your job at hand, you were a freelancer, but has that changed, you know, somewhere? Do you plan to do something else with your life now?
Currently, I'm actually looking up for opportunities. So it's like whatever opportunity I feel like, okay, I can dedicate myself to, I'll do that. So as I say ki, okay, it's worthless doing things where you can, you know, dedicate half of your attention to. Currently also I was sitting here, friends used to say, Gaurav, because here also I never told anyone because people got in touch with me, I never said. So people used to say, ki, why don't you get in touch with these people, media and persons or something. So I said, I have one thing in front of me, that is cycling. If I go into other things, there are many things that I can do. But thing is, for now, let's cycle, okay?
Okay. So if someone paid you for the rest of your life to cycle and go on such trips, would you just take it?
I don't think so, because cycling is over now. Cycling over. Maybe I'll cycle it. That's not something that I can put up right now. But if I'll have something, yeah, I'm open to opportunities. If I'll get something interesting to do, I'll obviously do that. And yeah, if I like something, I'll do that.
Okay, so now you've gone from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. So there is no plan of going from Gujarat to Assam or Leh Ladakh or something like that?
I plan to start from Ladakh, but at that point of time, the roads were closed because it was February. It was might be snowing or something. So I don't like traveling actually. I just wanted to go on a journey.
So you don't
journey.
Like traveling?
You don't,
you
like,
don't
cycling.
Like cycling? And still you're going from Kashmir to Kanyakumari.
It's like you
on
like
a
it's like you like cooking food but you don't like eating it. So I like cycling but I cycle but I don't like cycling. Yeah, can say
okay,
that.
Okay, you cycle but you don't like cycling, but you know your friends have helped you out a lot is what you said. They try to connect you to a lot of people in to the
Yeah, friends were very helpful and friends like had helped me, they connected me to people, they connected me to the fellow friends and they even found out accommodation for me. So friends were helpful. Yeah.
Okay,
friends
so
were definitely
all
helpful.
All those friends who initially were doubtful of your intention, what do they say now?
Actually, they were not doubtful of the intention, they were doubtful of the fact ki, okay, is this something that we are hearing, is it really true or not? You know, it's very abrupt out of the word thing, ki, okay,
yeah.
You're traveling on a bicycle that to end of the country. So that happens, I won't blame them for it, so they're fine. But there is a thing that I have met so many people that I keep forgetting them, I keep forgetting their names and what do they do. So I think then they ask me, okay, we met here, but you didn't reply back after that. So I think when I'll go back, the very first work I'll do is I'll reply all of them back.
Okay.
Okay? So I'm very sorry if I didn't reply anyone back here.
Well, we're in talks with the Gaurav, the young man who's been traversing the country with his cycle since 14th of February. Gaurav has been traveling from Kashmir and now he has reached Bengaluru and he plans to go all the way to Kanyakumari. So we were just talking to him about his journey and how it has all turned out for him, how it has changed him, what was his best and worst experiences, the kind of friends that he's really made. And now we'll just ask him. His parents have been extremely supportive of his journey. Gaurav, your parents have been very, very supportive of what you've been doing.
Yeah.
What really have they told when you're going through this journey?
I think initially it happens as I told you, you know, everybody is very skeptical ki kar payega, nahi kar payega. It's a different thing. They knew ki I would do it, but point is they had a little bit of, you know, doubt ki, you know, what might happen. So
your relatives did not come and say, how can you let him go?
There was a friend I wanted to take along. His parents said, we won't even allow your parents to let you go. Was it? So they didn't even allow their kids, so that's the reason why I went alone. But now I think that going alone was a better idea because I meet so many friends just because of the reason, you know, I'm here alone.
Yeah.
And otherwise, had I been with a company, I would be busy, you know, indulging and, you know, having fun with the company. So I think it was fine. Everything, you know, later when you see, all that ends well is, you know, well.
Yeah, absolutely. All that ends well. All is well. Any word of advice to the people out there? Just something from what you have learned in the last 42, 44 days. Any word of advice to the people?
Same thing as I mentioned earlier. Keep, if you think something that you can do or you, if you have a passion for something, I think bahut purana dialogue hai, rata vata. And the point, you know what is, ki if somebody has experienced it, he tells it to someone. So people are like, you know, he's saying the same thing. But I think that happens, okay. So until and unless you lose it in your mind, you won't lose it.
Yeah.
Okay. If you lose it, if you give up in your
Absolutely.
Mind, so it's everything stops from there.
Right.
Okay,
yeah.
So I think never give up. And I think learning should, travel is a different thing. Had it been something else also, if it has your mind there involved, So I think don't give up. If it's traveling, if it's your job, even if there are people in the job, they shouldn't give up. At least keep on trying for whatever you want, for whatever you have joined it for. So yeah, that is it. Go for your passion.
Absolutely. Go for your passion. Live your dream is what Gaurav goes on to state. And he's not just merely stating words. He has walked the talk, or rather cycled the talk. So it's about time that you do go out there and live your dream. And there will be nothing that you will repent in the future. With that, it's a wrap on this special broadcast. Thank you, Gaurav, so much for joining us in our studios. It was a pleasure to have you here. Up next, the News9 Entertainment Report. Stay tuned.